John chapter 15, verse 16. You did not choose me, but I chose you. I appointed you that you should go out and produce fruit, and that your fruit should remain, so that whatever you ask the Father in my name, he will give you.
Welcome to Scripture Picture, day 5 of Making and Moving. I'm Christina. I'm so glad you're here with me so we can look at God's Word and we can look at another example of Jesus choosing a very unlikely person to follow him and to spread God's love with the world. This is a story coming from Acts chapter 9, verses 1 to 19. It's the story of Saul turns to Paul through Jesus. Let's take a look.
This is Saul. Saul was a Pharisee who hated the followers of Jesus so much that he would hunt them down to be brought to trial in Jerusalem. And he would even seek to murder them. Saul was uttering threats with every breath, and he was eager to kill the Lord's followers. So he went to the high priest. He asked him to write a letter to the Jews in Damascus that would allow him to arrest any Christians he found there. He wanted to bring them, both men and women, back to Jerusalem in chains. Now Saul went on his way. And as he came near Damascus, a light from heaven flashed around him, and he heard a voice that said, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" Saul cried out, "Who are you, Lord?" And the voice said, "I am Jesus. Rise and go into the city, and you will be told what to do." So Saul got up and he opened his eyes, but he couldn't see anything. So the men who were with Saul led him into the city. After 3 days, a man named Ananias came to Saul. He put his hands on Saul and immediately Saul could see again. And with that, Saul became a follower of Jesus. He became the very thing he had tried to hunt. And he immediately began telling people that Jesus is the Son of God, and he taught them about the mercy of God that he had received. And all who heard him were amazed. He then went by a new name, Paul, as he began preaching not just to the Jewish people, but to everyone. Despite many difficulties like being imprisoned, shipwrecked, and narrowly escaping death multiple times, Paul continued to preach about Jesus. Paul said that he would do everything he could to save people and help them know God. And that's just what he did in order to reach people who would otherwise be unreached. And many came to know Jesus because of what Paul said. Paul taught many in his day through his letters, but even more have come to learn more about Jesus through the letters of Paul that can be read even to this day.
When Jesus died, he made happen what many people were waiting for, to be saved from their sins. The problem was many people didn't believe Jesus was who he said he was, and they were not happy that his followers were telling people that he was the Son of God and that he was the only way to be forgiven from their sins because of his death and because he rose from the dead. They actually didn't believe that he actually rose from the dead, and they were willing to put anyone that said he rose from the dead in prison and even put them to death. Saul was actually responsible for a lot of the people that were imprisoned and put to death. Jesus' choice of Saul shows just how amazing Jesus really is. That it doesn't matter what we have done, his choice is based on what he can accomplish through a willing heart. As passionate as Saul was in keeping people from spreading the news of Jesus' death and resurrection and his saving grace to others, when Saul became one of Jesus' followers and he knew Jesus for himself, he became even more passionate about spreading Jesus' love and his good news to others. Just like Saul, or should I say Paul, it doesn't matter what we've done or the circumstances we face. As soon as we make that decision to follow Jesus, he wants us to share his love with others so that they can get to know him too and they can decide for themselves whether they will accept Jesus. Okay, so we are going to do a fun activity. You can make it a game. It's called Who Can Make the Longest Straw. If you do it by yourself, you can just try to make a long, long, long straw. If you're doing it with a partner, a sibling or something, you can see who can make the longest straw while still be able to be drinking or while still being able to drink liquid from a cup. So you have been given in your boxes 12 straws. You can use those 12 straws plus some tape. Watch the video to see how you can do it. But I want you to remind, while you're doing this activity, I want you to be reminded of why we're looking at these straws. So I gave you these straws because I want to remind you about following Jesus. Following Jesus doesn't mean just that Jesus changes your life. He wants you to share his love and his message with other people so that they can make that decision for themselves and they can be saved from their sin and have him come and enter the hole that's in their heart and make that decision for themselves. So just like that, when Jesus chooses someone, he wants that person to tell somebody else. And he wants them to help that person grow in Jesus by directing them to Jesus and his scripture and his love. And even maybe praying with that person and talking more and more with that person about what it's like to serve and to follow Jesus. And then that person tells somebody else about Jesus's love. And that person tells somebody else about Jesus's love. And pretty soon it's spread out from yourself to another country. That's what Saul did when Jesus came to him. Saul didn't just keep it to himself. He shared God's love with nations, and those nations told other nations, and pretty soon God's love was spread throughout the world. So just like that, just like this one straw can be connected to another straw, which can be connected to another straw, and then the juice can go through the whole straw, that's just what it's like with God's family. One person can tell another person who can tell another person, and those people that make those decisions, that love can be spread throughout the world. So I want you to keep that in mind. Have fun with the activity. The video is going to be just after this. Have fun with that activity, and I'm really glad for all of you that have made decisions to follow Jesus. Don't forget to keep talking to other people that love Jesus so that you can grow in your knowledge and in your faith with Jesus. Don't forget to tell us if you've made that decision. We want to give you a little something. We'll mail it out to you just to celebrate that decision and to encourage you further in your walk with Jesus. So don't forget to tell us, and we'll make sure to mail that out to you. I just want to encourage you to have fun with the rest of your day, and don't forget to make and to move. Bye. This is the longest straw activity. What you're going to need for this activity is a cup of water or juice or whatever you're going to drink. You're going to need some scissors, some tape, and the 12 straws that we gave you, the 12 bendy straws for this activity that was in your box. And it's really easy to do. All you do is you cut 10 out of your your 12 straws, and this is how you're going to cut it. Okay, so move this over a little bit. So you're going to just cut your straw like this. And you're just going to cut a little bit, or if you're not supposed to use scissors, and you can't do a discipline to, just cut a little bit, two little cuts on one end of the straw, and you're going to try to fit it over top of your easier to fit it over top of the next straw, and when you do that, then once you fit it over top, then you're gonna tape it so that no air can go through, and it's nice and sealed so that you're able to drink your water through it. Okay, so that's what you do. You can even test it out and drink a little bit, put a little bit in your water, try it out. Yeah, that works. Okay, so then you're going to take your next straw. You're going to do the same thing. You're going to just cut two little cuts on one end. It doesn't have to be long cuts, just two little cuts. Okay, and then you're going to fit it over top of one end of your straw and make sure that you tape it. And that's essentially all you do. You just keep cutting the ends of your next straw, and every straw that you do, you want to test it to see if the straw still works. And you gotta try, and you're gonna have those challenges to see if you can get to. Oh, see, I didn't seal that one properly. You want to see if you can get to 12 straws and still be able to drink the water out of the cup with 12 straws stuck together. You can do it as a game, you can do it longest, or you can just challenge yourself. How many straws can you connect and still be able to drink your water? Alright, and that's how you do it. I hope you guys have fun. Have a good rest of your day. See you later.